I'm going to talk to you about some of the long-term complications that you can see with diabetes. These are not things that will definitely happen. These tend to happen over a long period of time when you've had diabetes for a considerable amount of time and your blood sugars have been high. So, first off, I'm going to talk to you about eyes. You will have been invited, hopefully, to your eye screening within the first year of diagnosis. And this is to check for some of the signs of damage we can see with a long-term complication of diabetes. So this is a cross-section of an eye, a model. And what they will do is they will put some eye drops in your eye to open up the pupil, and they will take a photo of the back area of the eye. And this is the retina and the area just in front of the retina. And what they were looking for is for changes in the blood vessels and that sort of area in the back of the eye. So one of the things they will look for is something called a microaneurysm. Now these are bulges in the wall of the blood vessels. These can rupture, so that can cause a bleed in the back of the eye, and that is a cause for concern. Something else that they might be looking for is some things called hard exudates, which are little dots of the essentially fat that have exuded out into your eye. Sometimes they're yellow, sometimes they're white. And the final thing that they will be looking for is some new blood vessels that have formed. So what happens is sometimes the eye senses that there's a blockage in the blood vessel, and it will try to form new blood vessels around the blockage. These new blood vessels are very fine and wispy, and they can rupture easily and can often end up causing more harm than good. So they'll be on the lookout for those as well during your eye screening. That's not to say that if they do see some early damage that you will need any treatment, because some of it can be so mild that it doesn't need any treatment at all. What they might do is just invite you back in a few months' time for another eye screening to check there have been no further changes. And I have come across people that have had what this is called a background retinopathy for 20 years and they've not needed any treatment. It's not caused any effect to their vision and they can live essentially normally with this background retinopathy. If you do need treatment, it will usually come in the form of some laser treatment or occasionally eye injections. Something else I'm going to talk to you about is the long-term complication of something called nephropathy, which is a problem in the kidneys, a bit of kidney damage. Again, this is not something that will definitely happen to you. It tends to happen in people that have had diabetes for many, many years, and perhaps their blood sugars have stayed high over that time. So the kidneys are essentially filters for the blood, and you've got lots of fine blood vessels flowing through the kidneys, and unfortunately with diabetes that they can get a little bit damaged. One of the things they will be looking for in your annual review is the functionality of your kidneys, so that will be to check that there are no proteins in your urine, which indicate that they're not filtering correctly, and they will be checking as well your blood to make sure that the filtration rate of your kidney is still effective. So anything above 60% is good kidney function. But that's to say, it is normal to have a little bit of a decline in our kidney function as we get older. So don't worry if your numbers do go down a little bit year on year. That is normal. It's just that 60% we're looking for the filtration rate, 60 or above. And finally, I'm just going to talk to you about feet. Now, feet is a big area where we need to check on a regular basis that we haven't got any damage or anything suspicious looking. Because if you think about it, our feet are right at the end of our legs. We have our longest blood vessels and our longest nerves going right down to the ends of our feet. And unfortunately, over time, we can see a little bit of damage to both the nerves and the blood vessels in the feet. So we recommend that at least once a day, you have a visual check of your feet, just to make sure that there isn't a formation of anything new, like athlete's foot, or a new wound, or start of an ulcer, or something like that. Calluses, a thin and flexible callus on its own is not a cause for concern, but we can see some damage occasionally when you've got very thick calluses, because over time, with the pressure of walking on the thick callus, you can damage the soft tissue underneath the callus, and occasionally you can see ulcer formation there. So do check your feet just to make sure that there's nothing untoward happening. When it comes to cutting your toenails, please do so quite carefully. Just follow a gentle curve over the top of your nail with nail scissors or clippers. And then if you have any corners of nail left over on the edge of your toenail, just file them down gently with a nail file and you'll be fine. Because what we don't want is for you to cut down the side of your toenails, because that can lead to ingrown toenails, which can eventually pierce the skin, and then you've got an open wound on the foot. Other things to look out for: if you get corns, avoid, like the plague, the over-the-counter treatments, because they can damage soft tissue around the corn. They work by actually burning off the top layer of skin, and so you don't want to burn healthy tissue around the corn. Other things to look out for, as I say, athlete's foot. If you've got any damage to toenails, that could be a sign that you've got ill-fitting shoes. The same with things like bunions. So make sure that your shoes do fit properly, not too tight and not too loose. Another thing to look out for as well is seams on socks, because sometimes they can be quite lumpy and they can rub the skin and cause abrasions. So just make sure that everything is in order there. During your annual foot check, the nurse or the GP will be checking the sensation in your feet. So what they will do is, using a tiny fine filament, is just apply pressure gently to strategic points in your feet, and they will ask if you can feel them or not. Unfortunately, with diabetes, you can get nerve damage over a long period of time of having diabetes, especially if your blood sugars are high. And the problem is, if we lose sensation in the sole of our feet, sometimes we don't realise when we've trod on something sharp or injured our foot, which is why they are very keen to make sure that you still have good sensation in your feet, or to be aware if you're starting to lose a bit of sensation. Something else to be aware of as well when you're checking your feet: if you spot anything untoward on a Friday night, please don't leave it until Monday or your next foot check to get it checked out, because things like infections or toes that are starting to turn a little bit blue, they can turn quite nasty in just 48 hours. So the best thing to do if it's a Friday night is call NHS 111 to ask their advice. If they think it's serious, they may actually send you to A&E to get it properly dressed and looked at, just to make sure it doesn't get out of hand. We recommend that you moisturise your feet every day with a moisturiser containing an ingredient called urea. Urea is important because that ingredient is something we naturally produce in our skin, but with diabetes we see that a bit less so. So urea actually works by breaking down hard skin and softening hard skin. And that's why it's particularly good. So if you look on the ingredients of your foot cream, make sure it's got urea in a concentration somewhere between 10 to 25%, and that would be perfectly adequate. And just moisturise once a day. A couple of other things to look out for with type 2 diabetes. They're long-term complications, so you won't definitely find this, but do look out for the higher risk of stroke and heart attack.